A choice every employer will have to make when considering a construction project is what procurement route to choose. And if you're a QS, it's often your job to advise the client on what route they should take. The preferred decision will differ depending on the client's circumstance, aims, and objectives. In this video, we're going to compare the four most common procurement routes and explore the pros and cons for each. Before we begin, we'd be really grateful if you could give this video a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe so you can see our new uploads every Wednesday. So let's begin. We'll start with traditional procurement route, perhaps called traditional due to its usage dating back to Victorian times. Under this method, an employer would engage a contractor to carry out the construction of a project in accordance with the design produced by the employer's professional team. Throughout the construction, the client's design team holds responsibility for the design, while the contractor holds responsibility for the construction. Pros to this route include: client has greater control of design, there is a familiarity of this route between construction parties, and if the design is fully scoped before tendering, then greater cost certainty is achieved. Cons to this route include: due to the split responsibility of design and construction, disputes can often arise as to where the fault lies for defects. Construction lifecycle is elongated, as the client has to engage multiple parties, and ideally, the design needs to be complete before engaging the contractor. Also, while you're here, why not join our Telegram group? Here you'll be able to speak directly with us and other like-minded quantity surveyors. If you're interested, we've left the link to the group in the description of this video. Next, we have design and build. There are various forms of design and build contracts. However, the general concept remains the same. The contractor has both responsibility for design and construction of the works. Under integrated design and build, the contractor undertakes the design and construction based on a set of requirements from the employer. Under novated design and build, the employer hires a design team to complete the design before it is novated to the contractor during construction, who will then assume design responsibility. Pros to this route include: there's a single point of contact for both the design and construction of a project, enabling greater project efficiency. And works can start before the design is complete, meaning an earlier start time on site. Cons to this route include: there's a lack of design control for the employer. Contractors can often compromise on design to bring the cost of a project down, and there is greater responsibility placed on the employer to be clear with their design requirements. Moving on, we have management contracting. Similarly to traditional route, the design is carried out by a professional team appointed by the employer. However, under management contracting, the employer also appoints a management contractor to manage the construction works. The management contractor does not carry out any of the works themselves. However, they engage a series of subcontractors who they manage and coordinate. They are paid an agreed fee and reimbursed for the cost incurred to manage the subcontractors. Pros to this route include: client can retain control of design while drawing on the experience and expertise of the management contractor. The client can move risk of procurement and delivery to the management contractor, and design and construction can be overlapped, allowing an earlier start time on site. Cons to this route include: this method is not suited for inexperienced clients. Total risk cannot be transferred to the contractor, and there is less cost certainty for the employer. And lastly, we have construction management. This is a slight variation to management contracting. Under this route, a construction manager is employed to manage the construction works. Unlike management contracting, the construction manager is a member of the client's team who will advise on the construction as well as manage it. The contractors are directly employed by the client, meaning the construction manager holds no risk for the works above his reasonable skill and care. The construction manager is paid a fee for their services. Pros to this route include: client's involvement is much higher when compared to other routes. This can promote a better working relationship with the project team. The client has a direct contract with the smaller contractors, thus improving their cash flow. There's more opportunity for value engineering. Cons to this route include: client must involve themselves in all course of works. They'll need to manage both the construction manager and the design consultants. There could be a lack of available specialists in the project team, and risk to the client is high, as they will be in direct contract with the smaller contractors. Metroun, a commercial hub to your business.